All right, so you do marketing. What's the greatest marketing campaign any musician's ever utilized?
The greatest marketing campaign?
Is there something that inspires you?
The biggest... All right, I don't know if this is... I was young, so I don't know, like, the real truth of what happened. 50 Cent's Get Rich or Die Trying campaign was something that early on made me want to be in the music business. It was the first time that it ever... It was, like, 2003. It was the first time that it ever, like, connected with me about how important storytelling was. Because everybody knew 50 Cent's story down to, like, the smallest details. And it wasn't hard to find. Like, it was everywhere. And it made you invested in the music. And then the music was great. His was a big one. I think Bryson Tiller, actually, a couple years ago, kind of shifted the paradigm when he did the Trap Soul project and he dropped Don't. It shifted him and Post Malone shifted the way SoundCloud was utilized. With, you know, repost campaigns and influencer marketing. Like, that was stuff that was definitely ahead of the current space. And then the other one is Wiz and what Benji and Artie did with touring and social media marketing and, you know, really hand-to-hand combat marketing, building Fan a Day, grassroots, treating it in... Like, the Wiz Rostrum Records game plan is now the way that every indie label wants to be. And half of them don't even give them credit. Those are the three off the top of my head. And then they did it with Mac, too. Those are the three.